And now, live in studio, cutting through your typical media nonsense and offering you a rational and unbiased perspective on current events and life in Tampa Bay, he's a successful entrepreneur, a real estate and finance expert, and goes to bat for you every day as your consumer advocate. Your host, Brandon Rhymes.
Yes, here we are again another day committed to picking a fight with the mainstream media and providing you the timely truth centered around your real estate, credit, finance, estate planning, tax planning, and so much more. Over 75 show partners now associated with the Real Estate Quarterback Show and our second brand, the Consumer Quarterback Show, with our number one goal being to educate, entertain, and engage in an effort to help you win in any marketplace.
The only thing I'm addicted to right now is winning.
Now, I want you to pull out your smartphone and save your consumer advocate hotline number in your phone. It's 813-917-1894.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
813-917-1894. Now, that's our consumer hotline. We want you to call, text in. You can call, leave a voicemail. Our promise is that we're going to get back to you before our head hits the pillow. And we are Tampa Bay's number one consumer advocate. And we want to help you with all these different decisions that you have on a daily basis. Also, we want you to bookmark our website. It's realestateradiotampa.com. Realestateradiotampa.com. You can see it's our blog site. You can see links to all of our real estate listings. And most importantly, all of our expert contributors have an announcement card there that has their website, phone number, and contact information for all of the finest folks in all of Tampa Bay. And again, we want you to think of this show as the hub of your financial wheel, which each spoke extending out representing another one of our preferred partners. So all types of categories to help you, six or seven different types of law that we focus on with this show as well. So it doesn't matter if you're climbing a corporate ladder or if you throw a ladder in your truck on the way to work, this show's for you and we want to help you win. This segment is brought to you by my health team consisting of Michael Vogt. He's an expert massage therapist here in Tampa Bay. Michael Vogt shouts out, he's voted one of top 10 massage services in Tampa Bay as voted by the Tampa Bay Business Journal's Best in the Biz Awards. And located at 3750 Gunn Highway here in Tampa Bay. Shouts out to Michael Vogt, the best massage therapist in Tampa Bay, as well as Ray Milton. He is known as the Ray's Vegan Soul. He cooks these awesome meals for me, vegan-style food. A wonderful idea as a busy sales professional out there. Reach out to Ray on Facebook at Ray's Vegan Soul. Do a search for him. Ask us for an introduction, and he's going to create some awesome meals for you and help you live a cleaner life. And let's go ahead, and also we have an open house going on this weekend. I want to give shouts out to Andrew. He's going to be over here at this property at 4702 South Himes Avenue in Tampa. Beautiful South Tampa property. It's in the Oak Leller subdivision. Three bedrooms, one full bath, and one half bath. And the open house is on Sunday from 11 to 2. Go ahead and swing by. The owner's motivated. Nice pool home, large lot, and a great buying opportunity here in beautiful Tampa Bay. All right, let's go ahead and round the horn here, make our introductions. It's Intelligent Talk Radio. I've got some intelligent folks here in studio with me. And first up, seat number one is Michael Banner. He's a well-respected reverse mortgage specialist here in Tampa Bay, Professional Mortgage Alliance. Welcome in, sir.
Thank you very much. Here to help people above 62 years old purchase a home with no payments. How much easier can it be, Brandon, a home with no payments?
Oh, beautiful. Love it. Love it. We're going to touch base on that, the reverse for purchase and all different types of ways to utilize this. A great program called a reverse mortgage, the home equity conversion mortgage. We're going to talk about that. Also in studio, Abe from Total Title. Welcome back in, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much for having me back.
Excellent.
We're talking about the Foreign Investment and Property Tax Act today. So hit me with some questions.
Hey, a lot of foreign investment happening, and you know it's a great opportunity when you think about a lot of the currencies, a lot of the uncertainty out there in the world markets. You know, there's a lot of money flowing into the United States, and we're also going to talk with James about that. By the way, next seat is James Lascano, Transworld Business Advisors, helps people with valuation of their business, and he's a business broker, so he can help you buy or sell a business. So I'm sure we're going to touch about some of that foreign buyers coming into the marketplace as well.
Definitely got a great story. Actually, speaking to somebody today about that. And yeah, if anybody wants to buy or sell a business, give me a call. I have a immense plethora of businesses for sale, as well as I can help you also within the business buying of it or selling of it.
That's right, and go Bolts. You know, we're pulling for our local team here, Tampa Bay Lightning, making another push here in the playoffs. Great things happening in Tampa Bay, and we're here in studio live from iHeart, where you can find our show every day, 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., and also on the weekends. We're on the 102.5 The Bone on Sunday morning, 7 a.m., and you can watch all of our TV shows. Just as a reminder, our TV show, this show is streaming live. As you're listening, it is live, so if you're by a computer or on your iPhone particularly, you can pull up the Google Chrome app and pull up our website, realestateradiotampa.com, and you can also stream it as well from WeBeam TV, another one of our partners. Shouts out to Josh and John Gasson over there at WeBeam TV. So let's go ahead and jump into this. If you're just joining us, you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show. We're going to be talking with Michael Banner here with Professional Mortgage Alliance, and it's also the American C.E. Institute. So what say you, sir? What's new in your world, man?
Well, it's time to learn the truth about reverse mortgages. That's why I'm here.
You can't handle the truth.
There you go. And that's true. Most people can't handle the truth about reverse mortgages. Truth of the matter is for the last 30, even close to 40 years, many people don't want to admit this. It was a flawed product, Brandon. Mm-hmm. It was too expensive. It didn't have the protections for the borrower, or the remaining borrower, which is usually mom, yep, because dads die first. And that's just a
why is that, I wonder?
Because they want to.
Yeah, we work harder?
Men die first because they want to.
We're ready to go.
Yeah, we've just had it. there's no way. Okay, so all the women just turned off the radio. Okay,
just
no
kidding, problem. Ladies.
Just kidding. Just kidding. No, but the truth of the matter is many people don't think about this, you know, when they're buying a house. And I'm not even talking about reverse mortgages now. But when you purchase a home, and God forbid, of course, it's Florida. We're in the retirement capital of the country. Average age of a person in Florida, I think, is like 112, something like that.
Yeah.
You know, most of the children in Florida actually, qualify for reverse mortgages. We're in reverse mortgage heaven.
You know, political facts going to be on you right now.
Yeah, I know. It's okay. But the truth of the matter is, when you meet people in your 60s, in their 60s, and let's forget reverse mortgages, any mortgage, fast forward 25 years later, dad is 88, mom is 85. Dad goes first. You know, in the middle of all of this loss, tragic loss, you know, very seriously, many people don't realize that mom just lost probably 60 to 70% of the household income.
Right.
Mm-hmm. She lost dad's Social Security. She lost dad's pension. Even in his 80s, he was probably coordinating the pool and the lawn and the this and things being done. So in the midst of this great emotional loss, there's a staggering financial loss. And I know there's people out there that'll agree with this. At many, many funerals, you know, or at home, somebody's going, how is mom going to keep the house? And as much as people don't think about that, if they did decide to have a reverse mortgage 20, 25 years earlier, the question isn't how is mom going to afford the house, because there's no payment. The question is, do you think mom wants to stay in the house? Because mm-hmm. where else can you go and live for free?
Yeah.
Okay. Unless you're, going to go live with one of your children, which is not always the case and, or not always possible. So to think that you could really have that kind of effect on a family mm-hmm. 25 years after the closing, after you shook their hand and said, good luck with your new house, and now you're responsible for something like that. It's turned into a very noble industry. And again, in April of 2010, for the first time in 40 years, HUD ripped apart the program, put it back together, made it less expensive. A couple of years later, 2012, they increased the protections for the borrower and the estate. No, you don't lose your home with a reverse mortgage.
Right.
I don't care what anybody tells you. I don't care what they say. You don't lose your home as long as you pay your taxes. Got to pay your taxes in this country, unfortunately.
Uncle Sam's got to get his piece. Mm-hmm. The governor's got to play golf.
Absolutely. Yeah, you got to do, what you got to do. We got to keep that $18 trillion debt growing in this country. So it's just turned into, it's gone literally, Brandon, from a needs-based product of last resort. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, mom is broke. I guess we need one of those lousy reverse mortgages, into a true retirement planning tool. And the purchase product, which I'm most excited about, is a product that was invented with HERA in early 2009, the Housing Economic Recovery Act. It is a totally different reverse mortgage. The math is the same,
yep,
but this enables people to purchase a home
yeah.
with a reverse mortgage rather than pay cash. And to think about, again, you know, how many people, especially seniors, had took losses 2007, 2008
yep.
To be able to retain so much liquidity.
Yep,
and still meet your goal of no payment. It's exploding throughout the country, and that's our specialty.
And we're going to walk through a example. You know, I love the example. Absolutely. Sometimes Michael's such a great speaker. When you break it down and make it make common sense for the folks, and how it would be applicable in today's environment, where a lot of times folks are moving from up north, coming down to Florida. But we're going to have more from our experts as well. We're going to hear from Abe with Total Title Solutions and James Lascano, Transworld Business Advisors, and more from our experts here in studio with their number one goal to help you avoid a lot of the commission-based advice that you find out there. And so stay with us. The best is yet to come. You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, realestateradiotampa.com.
This is Warwick Dunn, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, hosted by my man, Brandon Rhymes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rhymes, host of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. This segment is brought to you by the Maid Cleaning Service. They do a wonderful job cleaning our real estate properties. Shouts out to the Maid. They are referred for a reason. The Maid Cleaning Service here in Tampa Bay. And check us out on our website. You can find all of the introductions you're going to need with most real estate, business, finance, estate planning, tax planing, over seven areas of law that we cover with this show at realestateradiotampa.com. And we want to touch on this open house. We've got 4702 South Himes Avenue going on Sunday, 11 to 2 p.m. It's a three-bedroom, one-and-a-half-bath pool home in lovely South Tampa here. Just reduced down to $259,000. And our property of the month, the hot property of the month here, is 414 South Royal Palm Way in Tampa. Beautiful beach park home here. Four bedrooms, three full-bath, two-half-bath, over 4,800 square foot heated space. And it is a distinguished style South Tampa home here, listed at $1.27 million. Great opportunity. By the way, if you're a seller out there, if you're on the fence, you're thinking about possibly selling, we offer a free home valuation. All you have to do is reach out to our home value hotline, and we're going to hook you up with a free valuation, free comparable market analysis on your home. Welcome to my house. Find out what the property's valued at. You know, the market has been improving, appreciating every year. Tampa Bay consistently ranking in one of the top five markets in the United States for different categories. And, you know, you never know what you can get for your property until you reach out. Now, we are in a severe lack of inventory marketplace. So, you know, if you're a buyer out there, you're going through this experience right now looking for properties. You understand what I'm talking about. And if you're a seller out there, this is a great time to get your dollar and maybe move closer to the beach, closer to work. A lot of different things you can do and take advantage of the low, low mortgage rates that are out there, 40 to 50 year low rates that we have. So let's go ahead and bring Abe into the conversation. Abe, he's the owner of Total Title Solutions. Welcome back in, sir.
Thank you, Brandon. Thank you.
Yeah. So what are you seeing out there,
so,
man?
I got a few things to tell you. You know, let me tell you something, a little bit about my company for a quick second, please.
Yep.
We're when you're talking and you say we're a consumer advocate, we're not one of those companies that hide behind doors. We're part of the community. Mm-hmm. We're ingrained in the community, and I'm proud to say that I've been part of the community for the last 26, 27 years, and I contribute back to that community. Recently, we were part of this Habitat for Humanity gala, and mm-hmm. I'm proud to say that the event raised $279,000.
Awesome.
Oh, I will have to take some credit for being there for that one. That's equivalent to building 3.5 homes for Pinellas residents or whoever qualify for Habitat for Humanity, or maybe just a small house and three other houses. So this was something we're very proud to be part of as well.
I love it. Yeah. That fits into our Tell Me Something Good segment we do there.
Well, I figure I'll skip that one for you. So, anyway,
I
want to talk today about FIRPTA. People ask, what is FIRPTA? It's the Foreign Investment in Property Act, Tax Act.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, everybody knows, like earlier you said, we have to pay our taxes, right?
Right.
You have to pay taxes no matter what. So in a bubble, when the bubble burst, there was a lot of foreign buyer that flocked to Florida, in particularly, whether from South America or,
yep.
or Canada or whatever. There was a lot of people that bought property in the state of Florida. Well, now the market is good, the market is hot, and people are selling.
Yep.
So who's responsible for these taxes? I mean, the average person. Well, I want to go back on this one. When you want to sell your house or buy a house, please hire a professional,
right.
A good real estate agent, whoever you can trust. But start with a good real estate agent to list your house or help you buy a house. Of course, start with a competent title company, which would be us, and many others are out there are good.
Yep.
Good loan officer or good financial company.
Mm-hmm.
So always start with a competent company. But then this one here, back to that one. Of course, we have to pay our taxes. But typically, the person that produced the income mm-hmm. is required to pay those taxes. Well, not in this case. To my surprise, and this one, and many people's surprise, is the buyer is responsible for that tax.
So it's a way to tax foreigners a little bit more when they're purchasing properties in the United States, correct?
No, it's the other way around. When you're purchasing the properties, no problem at all. It's when, as a foreign person, as they find that you don't have a green card or legal status in a country, when you're trying to sell your property
out
the open market, and as a buyer says, oh, sure, I'm buying the property, great. The buyer, in this case, is responsible to pay the taxes.
Hmm.
The buyer. And it's a quite hefty. It's not like there. So there is a few exemption. If the property is under $300,000,
mm-hmm.
and the buyer agrees that he or she is going to live in the property for 2 years, 50% of the time, then it's okay. There is no taxes on that one. But anything above $300,000, all the way up to $1 million,
mm-hmm.
the buyer has mm-hmm. to withhold 10% of the purchase price.
Mm.
So it's quite hefty. And of course, if the buyer is another investor, he or she have to withhold 15% on that sales price.
Wow.
So think about it. There's a lot of responsibility here on the buyer as well. I mean, because the seller sells your property, walks away from it. And if we did not discover that the person is a foreign person, the IRS can come back and put a lien on your house as a buyer.
Wow.
They want their money. So that is, I would say, a twist. Like, a lot of people don't understand, why is the buyer responsible for this? Well, because the foreign may just leave the country. The only person that stays is the house is stationary. Well, we're going to place the responsibility on whoever can pay for the top.
There's a lot of uncertainty when it comes to those transactions, I think, is what's coming about. And you know, when you look at all the stuff happening on a geopolitical scale, you know, we've seen it. We see it, of course, the news outlets, the CNNs, the Foxes, the MSN, they're going to let us know all the negative things happening for sure. You know, and that's one reason why we started this show 3 years ago, is to have that positive spin. But, you know, when you have these things happening, you got the war in the Middle East, you got this new terrorism that's out there, and it seems like every other week there's a new, event that happens, you know. But it seems like the United States of America, Florida in particular, in our perspective here from the Southeast region, is the cleanest shirt in the dirty laundry. You know, it's the cleanest shirt in the dirty laundry. People want to be here. They love our infrastructure. You know, we talk bad about our government in some cases when it comes to an approval rating of Congress, about a 10% approval rating. You know, let's face it, I think Americans are fed up with a lot of the cronyism, the things happening in the marketplace. But, you know, bottom line is, people want to be here. We've got a great structure, and, you know, God bless the USA, man.
Absolutely.
God bless the USA.
God bless. Absolutely. I don't know if I always agree with you on that one. Somebody has to pay the taxes. They need to pay the taxes.
Let's dive
so
in there.
This is where I feel, with that government oversight, I will always have to disagree, although I'm with an accent, you can assume I'm a foreigner as well. I will have to say regulation, no matter what it is a must.
I agree.
I mean, whether it's too much or too little, we need to have it. And the abundance of it, I think, what makes us the greatest country on the earth. I don't think you want, look what happened in banking. When we leave the market to self-police itself, I think a lot of terrible things happen. So I'm in favor of the U.S. Congress and the American government at all times, despite how complicated that is.
Oh, yeah, because there's a lot of things we're not privy to. There's a lot of information we're not privy to. And we know that some of these, the lobbyists and these things are happening. But, you know, hey, it's kind of one of these things where it's a lesser of two evils. You know, we have this system. We've got to work with it. It's in place for a reason. And, yeah, I agree as well with what you're saying, Abe. You know, when we saw what happened in 06, 07, right in there, is they started reducing some of the regulation. They started allowing for a little bit of the Wild Wild West. And some of these loan products that were out there should have never been allowed. You know, the ones above 100% LTV, the no income, no asset ninjas, all those. You know, we've talked about that many times. But, you know, I think there's a fine line. Like, for example, we have the highest corporate tax rate on the planet. You know, you see companies like Burger King buying Tom Hortons out of Canada to avoid taxes. You see people.
Tim Horton.
Thanks for correction. But we see that, and I think that's what's resonating right now with the political arena. We're not religious here on the show. We're not politics. We're all about business. We want to help you. But, you know, it's interesting to talk about these things because, you know, when you see a businessman like Trump coming out and being very popular now, and then, you know, it's resonating with the American people.
Okay, so if we're gonna bring the topic of politics. I'm going to again have to say this from outside looking in on this.
Sure.
This is an election year.
Right.
A lot of negative stuff is out there, right?
Yes.
I'm going to say we are still the greatest country on the earth.
Absolutely.
With everything that we have and don't have and all the complainers, we're still the greatest. We're number one economical country in the world. Yep. How do you think we got here? It's because we did not regulate each other. It's because of everything that we did as a combination of whether it's Congress, President, everything else. This is how we got here. So please, we are a great country. We don't need to make America great again. We're always been great.
We got about 30 seconds left in this segment.
Absolutely.
So I love it. Let's when we come back, we're gonna, you know, I love how we're getting a lively conversation. We've got some you know, real estate roundtable discussion, mixing a little bit of current events and all kinds of fun stuff here with the Real Estate Quarterback Show. So stay with us. The best is yet to come. We're more from our experts here in studio, Michael Banner, Professional Mortgage Alliance. Abe, he's the owner of Total Title Solutions. James Lascano, Transworld Business Advisors. And I'm your host. I'm Brandon Rimes here, Platinum MVP Realty. So stay with us. The best is yet to come. RealEstateRadioTampa.com.
This is Work Done, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show hosted by my man, Brandon Rimes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, Real Estate Quarterback Show, Platinum MVP Realty. And this segment is brought to you by our friends over at Printing Solutions, Inc., digitalprintingsource.com. Shouts out to Greg over there. Does a great job printing some awesome flyers and pamphlets and business cards. Shouts out to Greg at Printing Solutions, Inc., digitalprintingsource.com. And we're having a lot of fun here in studio in Tampa, Florida, live from iHeartRadio, sunny and 75 here in beautiful Tampa, Florida. And got a hot property for this segment. I want to go ahead and give shouts out to Victor Alleman with Platinum MVP Realty. He's got a beautiful listing over at 249 Dogwood Trace in Tampa. I'm sorry, Tarpon Springs, Florida. Beautiful property here. $1.15 million for this beautiful estate-style home. It's in a luxurious estate with no details overlooked. Five bedrooms, four and one-half bath, 5,983 square feet. Four-car garage, 2,100-square-foot master suite, spread lovely over 4.5 acres. Shouts out to Victor over at Platinum MVP Realty. 249 Dogwood Trace, Tarpon Springs, Florida, listed at $1.15 million. Reach out at realestateradiotampa.com, or you can call our hotline at 813-917-1894.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
All right, all right. So we're kind of making the rounds here. We talked to Michael Banner, segment one. We just had a conversation with Abe from Total Title Solutions. We're going to come back and hear more from them. But I want to go ahead and get James Lascano involved in the conversation. He's with Transworld Business Advisors, and he's going to be able to help you in a capacity of valuing your business and maybe helping you buy a business or sell a business. James, welcome back in, sir.
Hey, thank you very much, Brandon. As always, I'd love to be here. One of the things I wanted to actually mention is a couple of things that I have, a couple hot listings right now. For example, I have a body shop at 29,000 square feet. It comes with all the equipment. It's already had the phase one and phase two done on it, and it's for sale for $1.6 million. It's a really hot area in Tampa. It even comes with a billboard, so a recurring revenue on that. I also have a beautiful school that's for sale for $1.8 million. The school nets $144,000. That's after a $10,000 mortgage that I included on there to make sure that whomever purchases it for the most times, mm-hmm. we have to include that because very few people pay cash for property of that size. So you'd be netting $144,000, which would include a mortgage already being paid with that. I also have an incredible restaurant right now for sale for $165,000. I could talk all day about this place. It has over $270,000 in assets. The reason the gentleman is selling is because it's too much work. He's making too much money and he can't manage. I mean, it's ridiculous. It sounds unbelievable, but it's run probably the hottest listing.
I want to have his problem.
Yeah. Well, it's coming. I mean, he's having problems because it's a lot of work. I mean, it's just ridiculous how much work he's doing.
Abe's place too.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah.
And the reason why, just for the listeners out there, the reason why James can't say, okay, here's the name of the company and the location is because he's respecting privacy and he's underneath a non-circumvention agreement or what's the other
confidentiality.
Form? Confidentiality agreement. So,
which is part of, in my job, it's funny, it's hard, it makes it harder, but we have to sell everything behind closed doors because we have to respect that the business and make sure that people don't know that the person selling the business to make sure that the revenue continues to flow. So
kind of
it's
a secret agent.
Huh? Yeah. Double a win.
Yeah, right.
Also to Abe's, if you have any questions, please give me a call. 727-217-5559. I'll be able to help you or call Brandon, of course, as a partner. We work together in a lot of things. So any which way you can get a hold of me, I'd love to help you out either sell or buy a business. Back to Abe's point, he's making great points. You know what? I've had the luxury to live abroad in my previous life in different businesses that I've worked in. And I will swear that I did this. I lived abroad for 2 years in one country. And when I came back, I swore when I would get back, I would literally kiss the ground. As I was getting off the tarmac, I kissed the ground. God, I love my country. Yeah. This country gives so much opportunity for mm-hmm. everybody and anybody. Oh, yeah. And it gives so much back. And, you know, it doesn't ask for much. You know, and I know that times it's old rhetoric, but what Kennedy said, you know, don't ask what your country can do for you, but do ask what you can do for your country.
Mm-hmm.
It is really something that should be, preached a lot more because, you know, a lot of people complain and everything is not perfect. We're nowhere near that, you know, mm-hmm. but I will stand by with anybody and say, look, go anywhere else and try to figure out how things are and then come back over here and see the opportunities you're going to have.
Yeah.
And being a first generation American, I preach that all the time.
Yeah.
You know, I mean,
that's why you see a lot of times the immigrants that come to the country, they're just overwhelmed with this opportunity and it hits them in the face. And that's why you see a lot of times the immigrants that make it to the country, you know, they're the ones that are starting these million-dollar companies, mm-hmm. multi-million-dollar companies, and they're able to because they don't have that. The spoiled brat kid that went to the prep school that got everything around there as well. So, Michael?
Well, I just wanted to say, because when I get to my segment, I'm going pure reverse mortgage, let me tell you. So I just wanted to very quickly end this segment with, this room is a proof of what this country is. We got a young man from Ecuador We have a man from
Lebanon.
Lebanon. We have a Jew from Queens. We have a Sicilian here running the show, and we have a realtor. You're your own.
Yeah, right.
Realtors are their own humanity.
His own ethnicity. And everybody that's
listening. But even though that, Portuguese and Irish. And, yeah. You know,
we're all here living the American dream, owning businesses. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to quote Don King.
Yeah.
Only in America.
Only in America.
Yeah. Only in America. Abe hit it right on the button. Thank you.
Let's jump back into, you know, the business side of what we're here for. By the way, if you just joined us, you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show. I'm your host, Brandon Rimes. I'm a top listing agent here in Tampa Bay. And we also have Michael Banner, you just heard from, Professional Mortgage Alliance. He also teaches at American C.E. Institute. He actually goes out and teaches other realtors, attorneys, CPAs, I believe, these
financial
different
planners.
Classes, financial planners. So it really is Intelligent Talk Radio here. When we say that, it's not a tagline or a slogan. We also have Abe as well. He's a serial entrepreneur. I mean, he's got multiple businesses out there. He's started businesses, sold businesses. He's the owner of Total Title Solutions here in Tampa Bay. And we're talking with James Lascano here, Transworld Business Advisors. So, you know, here's one of the things, James, that I always come back to when I think about this business that you have, and it's a great business, is that, you know, as a business owner, whether you're a contractor, maybe you have a small daycare or a restaurant out there, or, you know, whatever type of business you're in, you know, you've got to think, have this foresight. So many times I see people that they don't have the foresight to plan their escape strategy, their exit strategy, rather. So
no, sometimes it's escape. Sometimes it really is escape. They're just like, look, I'm done. Like, this restaurant owner, he wants to get out.
Yeah, there
he's like,
go.
I can't deal with it. It's too much work. But yeah, exactly. I mean, a lot of times we have to go and deal with anyone, one of the most basic concepts that we have to look at is the balance sheet and a profit and loss.
Yep.
You know, and some people have a gift, you know, or the experience. Restaurant owners, some restaurant owners will walk in and say, look, I can see it. I don't need to see the books. I know this place
makes
money.
No, it's a gift. You were correct, James. Mm-hmm. It's a gift.
Yeah, it's a gift. They understand it. And some people don't know anything, you know, and they have to go ahead and go down the line. And one of the things I also try to tell everybody who's trying to sell a business is be forthcoming, be completely transparent. I have met some people that try to get away with things, and I just tell them, look, a millionaire is not a millionaire because he's an idiot. They're very rare, and probably it was inherited, okay? Yeah. The people who work for their money do not just let it go.
Yeah.
So they rather hire and spend money to go ahead and make sure that the investment is going to be worth it. And I have a perfect example where a woman who nobody would think was such an – she is an unbelievable – unbelievably ace at her business, and because she surrounds herself with right people, and she's selling a business, she's buying a business for a few million dollars, and she says, look, I'm going to hire an appraiser, I'm going to hire an asset appraiser. I mean, she hired all these different, she didn't mind paying the money to find out that the business she thought she was buying for roughly about $2 million was actually worth about $1 million.
Yeah.
And you know what? It's, you're going to get to it. My job is to acquire the information from the seller and present it to a buyer. Okay. If I have a listing, and we all brokers tell them, look, give us the right information. It's going to come out because I'm going to figure it out. Someone else is going to figure it out. It's going to come out. And the person that's going to come out losing is you because you've lost all trust in the market. People are going to get really upset. So be as forthcoming with information as possible, because all you're showing is that you're an honest business person and all you're trying to do is sell your business for whatever personal reasons, but it will be an easier transition. It is critical.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And that's the goal of this show is, you know, there's a lot of different reasons why you want to check out our website, realestateradiotampa.com, because we're going to be able to link you with whatever type of professional you're looking for at that time. You might have $100,000 in debt, or you may have $100,000 to invest. We've got the full spectrum of different partners that can help you with these different situations. And we've got, you know, Sean Yesner, for example, a financial solutions attorney. We've got Michael Lasenko, Safe Money Coach, and everything in between. So we want you checking out our website. We've got a great YouTube library as well. Follow us on YouTube and Twitter and subscribe and check us out. So stay with us. The best is yet to come. More from our experts here in studio and realestateradiotampa.com.
This is Work Done, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show hosted by my man, Brandon Rimes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, host of the Real Estate Quarterback Show and the owner of Platinum MVP Realty. I'm a top listing agent here in Tampa Bay, featured in Florida Realtor Magazine, Tampa Bay Business Journal, The Tribune, and others. Recognized for innovations with marketing, I want to remind you our book is out. Check it out on Amazon.com, and please buy your copy and like it and share it and give us a review. We'd really appreciate that. It's the Real Estate Quarterback's Consumer Advocacy Playbook. And this segment is brought to you by Hula Bay. It's the official restaurant partner of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. A great location, great food, ambiance on the waterfront down in beautiful South Tampa. Shouts out to Hula Bay. Let's go ahead and enter our lightning round. Okay, lightning round. Top consumer tips, things to do, things to avoid. Michael Banner, you're up first, sir.
Consumer tips, use an expert, whether it's reverse mortgages, titles, conforming mortgages, a plumber. Don't listen to your neighbor. Don't listen to your brother-in-law that failed the bar exam three times. He's not an attorney, okay?
Yeah.
You know, and the guy that did your tax returns for $19, he's not a CPA.
That's right.
Use an expert. Whatever they charge, they're worth their weight in gold, and that goes triple for a professional real estate agent. Use a professional real estate agent when you're buying or selling a home.
That's right. And a lot of times there's a fiduciary capacity when it comes to these professionals. And like Michael said there, there's, you know, a lot of these professions, it only takes a 60-hour course or something like that. And there's a lot of sheep out there, people doing followers, they're followers. And you know, if you're out there listening and you can take offense to that, you're probably one of the sheep. So
that's right.
We'll go ahead and round the horn here. Top consumer tips, things to do, things to avoid. Abe, Total Title Solutions.
I would have to agree with Michael. I said this the last time I was here, is you truly do have to hire the professionals to help you. Mm-hmm. Don't be dollar foolish and penny wise. As far as I just want to touch up a little bit on the FRIPTA, there's a lot of forms to fill out. So my tip of the day for that, start with your tax identification number as a foreign person and get that, apply for that before you start selling your home. And for more information, go to our website, mytotaltitle.com. We have all kind of stuff on it, especially on that particular topic.
Awesome. Yeah, a lot of resources there on the website, I'm sure. Mytotaltitle.com. James Lascano, top consumer tip, sir.
Yes. One of the most important things is trust your broker. You know, when you're working with someone, provide him all the information and trust that he's giving you the right information once he's proven that he's an expert. One of the key things that I see a lot of times is people don't like to hear news when they tell them that the value of something is not what they expected.
Yep.
And you know what? The job is not to go ahead and give you the number that you want. It's to give you the fair market value of what it is in the market. So, you know, business is a little different than obviously selling real estate just for homes, because it takes a lot longer to sell a business. A business on average takes 8 to 10 months or even 12 to sell.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it, you know, a lot of people are going to be looking at this business after they signed a confidentiality agreement. So you want to make sure that you get the right information out there and price it right.
That's right. Yeah, definitely price the business or the property correctly. And to echo the points as well made by Abe and Michael, is when you're looking at these professionals, you know, check them out, make sure they're licensed, bonded, insured, and you know, and be a you know, an advocate for yourself. You know, that's one of the cool things that we love with this show is being that advocate, and also, you know, be creative. I would say if you're a business owner out there, let's be creative. We're doing a lot of joint venture marketing with Total Title now as well. We got some pretty cool Facebook sharing exercise that we're going to be doing, where we're offering an opportunity to co-host the show for the day. A lot of cool things happening with that. And I would just say be creative. You know, there's a great story I heard. One of my favorite speakers talks about he was in New York and he was traveling, and he's walking down the street and different people came soliciting for his business. They wanted to do a shoe shine. Hey, mister, let me shine your shoes. Nah, I'm too busy. I'm in a hurry. And, well, come on, mister. And the next guy, let me shine your shoes. And, no, I'm too busy. I got to go. And then the next guy comes up and turns and says, 97, 98, 99, 100. Excuse me, sir. Every year on my birthday, I like to offer someone a shoe shine. And would you do me the honor, sir? It's my birthday, and I would love to offer this to you. And he says, okay, fine. Yeah. So he sits down, and, you know, he had a different angle. So he sits down, he does the shoe shine, he turns around, and, you know, he says, oh, by the way, he gets done, he's walking out. He says, by the way, how much do you charge for a shoe shine? He said, oh, only $5, sir, only $5. He said, okay, well, look here. Here's $10. It's your birthday. Have a good one. And he turns around. He's heard the man walking. The man walks away in the opposite direction. 97, 98, 99. So, you know, it's about being creative a lot of times in business. So let's go ahead and enter
that
our
shoe-shine guy is now a realtor, by the way. So.
All right, we're going into our Tell Me Something Good segment here, Michael.
Well, this is actually a true story, which I didn't know what I was going to say for Tell Me Something Good until now. But I met someone, obviously we have to protect, you know, financials and privacy, but I met an incredibly wonderful couple that were building a house in Naples about 9 months ago. Just great people, all around great people. And they were building a house for $360,000 cash. Mm-hmm. And during construction, they were referred to me, not by their realtor, unfortunately, but by their financial planner. And they decided to do the purchase reverse mortgage. And again, just such polite, you know, you meet just great people.
Yep.
And adamant. Now, these were people with seven figures in the bank. These were not, wasn't Donald Trump, but they certainly weren't poor people, okay?
Yep.
I'm not spending more than $360,000. That's okay. So I gave them the good faith estimate. Nothing I can do. It's going to take 9 months to build the house. We closed on the house a few days ago, but last month when I updated the figures, they ended up spending $420,000. Nice. And I don't write many mortgages, but I happened to write that one.
Yeah.
So I called them and I said, "You were so adamant. I'm not spending more than $360,000. I'm just asking. I mean, let's face it. I make more money. It's a bigger mortgage." So. And they said, "Well, we just, as we thought about it, we just got the best of everything because we were going to spend $360 cash.
Yep.
We ended up spending $420. We're only putting up $210,000, 50% for the purchase reverse mortgage. So we spent an extra $60,000. I'm still saving $150,000, mm-hmm. and I still have no payments. So we got the best tile, the best swimming pool, the best hot tub. I have no payments. So to get that from a client, I mean, it's fun to pitch it with you and do this. But when you hear a client go, "You changed our lives. I mean, I have an extra $160,000 in liquidity in my dream
Michael,
retirement."
Did I hear that correctly? You did a reverse to actually build a house?
The builder built the house. I did what is known as the end loan. Yep. We took out the builder's construction loan with a purchase reverse mortgage.
Okay, you need to elaborate a bit more about that. Even that is a shocker to me that you're able to do that. So it's not just a home at the end of your days, basically. You could do it at any given moment.
As long as one of the borrowers is 62 years old and above, you can purchase a house from a builder. Builders love this house. Yep. We have loved this program because, I'm not giving away a secret here, builders make money on extras and power to them. It's mm-hmm. America.
Right.
And when you don't have a payment, I have national statistics. People are going, the 18-inch normal ceramic tile or the 24-inch Mexican, you know, I want that. Or I want a hot tub. I have no payment.
Yeah.
What a country.
It's great.
It is.
What a country.
And the realtors like it as well because they're selling.
Love it.
The realtors and the builders like it. They're getting a higher sales price, more commission.
And quite frankly, touching on the capitalism button, because that's what makes this country great.
Yep.
Once real estate people really and truly see that they can upsell a client, yet not hurt them financially.
Yep.
How often can you upsell someone and say, "But you still have no payment"?
Yeah, that's beautiful.
So when they can see that little capitalistic button going off, there it is.
Yeah,
that button just went off. That's amazing. When that button goes off in the realtor's mind, that maybe instead of purchasing a $300,000 house, they'll purchase a $400,000 house. Oh my! Did their commission just go up 33%? Again, what a country!
Love
what
it.
A country.
Tell me something good, Abe.
I thought I did earlier, but I'll share some story from the business. Recently, one of my employees came in and was asking me about this deal, and this lady trying to purchase a new house and want to pay off her old mortgage. And come to find out, the old company that did close for her paid off the wrong mortgage. So she thought she was totally paid off. It took us a little bit, but we were actually able to track down the people and they were honest enough and reversed everything else. And she was able to sell a house, buy a house, and everybody was happy.
Hey, I love that. It worked out. Everything worked out fine. Tell me something good. James?
Hey, Brandon. Well, I know that a lot of people have been watching the news and heard about the recent tragedy that hit the small South American country of Ecuador. Both my parents are from Ecuador. And here, I like I love the Tampa Bay community. The Latino community here is very united, and they have united this Thursday between, which is tomorrow, between 6 and 9 p.m. At 8307 West Hillsborough Avenue, the Club Ecuador of Tampa, to go ahead and donate clothes, food, water, anything will be taken, and it will be shipped over to Miami, where it will be sent down to Ecuador to help the relief efforts over there.
That's great.
It's I'm very proud to be. I'm not a Tampanian by birth. I'm a New Yorker by birth, but I'm an adopted Tampanian. I love this community. I had someone earlier today who was thinking of moving to Tampa, purchasing a business, and he asked me, "Tell me about Tampa." I said, "Look, you can't find a better place in Florida.
Absolutely
Tampa's
not.
Tampa's amazing.
Absolutely, United States of America, the best place to live, work, and play for sure."
I thought when you're born in Tampa, you're a tampon. That's not right.
Tampanian.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I learn something new every day.
Check us out. Check us out online. Sorry. Help out with the relief efforts there. And James, that's real close to our office down there. I think I'm gonna.
Yes.
I'll run some stuff down there too and support that. But hey, go out and please consider making a random act of kindness. We'll see you next time and place. Take care.